Postseason baseball on the show as we welcome you to Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the New York Mets and the Milwaukee Brewers. It's going to be a premier pitching matchup. Two of the league's hardest throwers go head-to-head next.
Milwaukee Brewers.
And stepping in, Jonathan Villar. He will lead this one off today. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. The temperature here at first pitch, a very seasonal 63 degrees this afternoon. High in the air down the right field line. Garcia on the run. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. So the next to bat will be Brandon Nimmo. His career numbers against this pitcher. He's 2 for 3. The 1-1. Hit out towards second. Taken in by Wong. Throw gets him. Two down. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor. Bases are empty here with two men out. And we'll watch the fastball miss down low. It's 2-1. Two balls and two strikes, the count to Francisco Lindor.
Let's get it going, boys. Somebody's loose hitting 98 with.
We'll leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Colton Wong will stand in. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 2-1. Taken, strike two. And this pitch is popped straight up right around the home plate area. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. So bases are empty with one gone. And up next will be Willie Adames. Now the 1-1 pitch. He's in there for the second strike.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And there are two away now. Now at the plate here is Christian Yelich. Two out, nobody on. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Soft liner toward first. Oh, what a stop on the slide. In time. Set for the start of the inning, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Pete Alonso. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. So next to bat will be Michael Conforto. His prior history versus this arm, he's a 333 hitter. Fastball just missed above the zone. Javier Baez is on deck. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full 3-2. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
So it was a swinging strike three. Michael Conforto goes down for out number two in the top half. 1-1. Skied into very shallow right. Garcia has a read on it, and that's the third out. So here is Abisaio Garcia. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Here comes the 1-2. On the ground to the left side. And there's one down now. Digging in now for the Brewers, Omar Narvaez.
Omar Narvaez.
And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Throw in time at first for out number two. So two out, nobody on, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. All even now, 2-2.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off.
Three balls and two strikes to Eduardo Escobar. That's fouled off to the left side as he makes him do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Hard hit ball to second. And a good effort on the dive that time, but this will get by him for a base hit.
Batting seven, the first baseman, number 20.
Into the box now, Daniel Vogelbach.
Ball, that's out.
Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1.
Hey.
Over at the knees, and that's the second strike. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Another 2-2 offering.
3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
A bouncer up the middle. There's Baez. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first. Saves an error as the side is retired. Digging in will be Jeff McNeil. Prior history in this matchup, he's gone 2-for-5. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fouled away.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Adames has it, and there's one gone. Up next, James McCann. Third inning, no score to this point. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Here now the 2-2. Is swung on and missed. He got him. Next to hit will be the pitcher, Marcus Stroman. This guy's still looking at a zero in the hit column. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. One ball and two strikes to count. Mets are still looking for their first hit of the ball game. Lays off, 2-2 now.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Bottom of the inning now. That'll bring up the center fielder Lorenzo Cain. The 1-1. Line to the right side. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. So the Brewers get their leadoff man aboard to start out the frame.
Batter done. And a pitcher. Roger.
To the plate now, Brandon Woodruff. Takes a good swing, but this will be a foul ball. 1-2. Oh, right back to him on the mound. To second for one. On to first. So they let him swing with two strikes, and it'll cost him as it's a double play. So the base is empty now after the double play. And that'll give way to the veteran second baseman, Colton Wong. swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Over to first, and that retires the side. All set for the start of the fourth, and set to go is the third baseman, Jonathan Villar.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
Fouled off. Fastball laid off well below the knees.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
And the throw will indeed take care of him for the first out. So bases are empty with one out now. And ready to bat next, the Wyoming native Brandon Nimmo. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Ani pops it up. And no one will get this one.
Hey, last two pitches back-to-back off-speed, then he's late on the fastball. He could pretty much do anything he wants right here on the mound.
The 3-2 pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Yelich is under it. He's got it, and there are two down now. So two are gone in the Mets half of the fourth. That'll bring up the switch hitting shortstop and perennial MVP candidate Francisco Lindor. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. 2-2. And he fouls this one off. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Stepping in once again is Willy Adames. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-1 home. Is taken for strike two. Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one. And here's Christian Yelich now. No runs, two hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. To two balls and two strikes now. On the ground is second for Baez. Reined in, and he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out. So the bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Avisaíl Garcia. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Side 3-2. Line shot to second, but it's caught and the side is retired. So here's the cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there, north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
So he gets him swinging on a pitcher's pitch. Pete Alonso is retired to lead off the fifth. Inside and low, 2-1. High pop up. Escobar is there. And he makes the catch for the second out. Here's Javier Baez. Flied out in his first at bat, so making 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. So now here is Narvaez, grounded out in his last at bat. 1-1. And he misses 2-1.
Hey, I hope that call doesn't throw him off his game right here. He's been pitching one heck of a game, and I'd hate to see the umpire get in his head right now.
2-2. This pitch is popped up. VR might try to make a play on it, and no one can get there. It's a foul ball. Well off the inside that time as the sinker misses for a ball.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Digging in next, Eduardo Escobar. One for one with a single so far. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. Oh, forget about this one. Ba-ba-booey. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. Into the box, Daniel Vogelbach. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The next 1-2 pitch. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out. So one gone in the Milwaukee fifth. And that'll bring up Lorenzo Cain. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Racing back to center fielder to the track. Out of here into the visitor's bullpen. At the plate, Brandon Woodruff. And he got him. Now back to the top of the Milwaukee order, digging in Colton Wong. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Drives it to deep right field. Right fielder looking up, and it's gone as they add still another. Standing in now, Willie Adames. Too much dip on the sinker, laid off for a ball.
Well, I think he just kind of lost focus on the mound right there. It's clearly not going his way, and he's thinking more about that than the task at hand. And right now, he needs to think about this hitter.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
He's under it, and that ends the inning. So here's Jeff McNeil, flew out in his only at bat so far. Now the 2-1 pitch. On drive, base hit to right. Stepping in now, James McCann. Chopped out is short. Can they get two? Adames brings it in. And the throw to first is in time. One gone. Luis Guillorme will get a chance with a runner in scoring position here as he'll pinch hit now with one away. No runs, just one hit, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Jonathan Villar. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Two balls and two strikes to Jonathan Villar. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball game, and this one ends the inning. Trevor Williams enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 29.
In is Christian Yelich. He grounded out last time up. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Throw to first is in time for the first out. So here's Abisail Garcia. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips. Bases are empty. One man out. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. Williams, a right-hander standing 6'3". He was taken in the second round back in the draft of 2013.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Hits this one hard the other way. And there's his first base hit in this one.
Now batting, catcher, Omar.
Into the box now, Narvaez. Weak grounder down the first baseline. And there's out number two. So here's Eduardo Escobar. He's got hits in both of his at-bats so far in this one. Garcia stands at second with two gone. And this one's in the dirt. The throw will go to third. And he nails him at third. Great throw. Seventh inning ready to roll. And at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Brandon Nimmo. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now Nimmo connects out to deep right field. Gone. He finds the short porch for a home run. At the plate now, Francisco Lindor. Come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now.
He didn't get him to offer at that pitch right there, but that big 12-6 curveball is definitely part of the reason he's having such good success in this one.
A bouncer to the left side. And the throw on to first will take care of him, so he's thrown out by the only man standing on the left side of the infield. One away. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Now the pitch. Fastball too low, and that's ball four. So here is Michael Conforto. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at-bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
And it's fouled away.
Obviously, he's not fatiguing whatsoever. Still in the mid to high 90s with his fastball. These guys got to stay on the attack if they're going to have a chance.
In the dirt here. And a good idea to hang close at first as he'll make it back easily. Here's the 2-2. He's just rolling right now. And even dozen strikeouts for him in the ballgame. So it's a runner at first with two men out. And with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. On a line, that's a base hit.
the batter, number six.
So now to the plate, Jeff McNeil. Off speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Just got a piece to the right side. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. Ready with the 2-2.
Looks to me like he's starting to labor a bit out there right now. He's pretty deep into this thing, and he's throwing a lot of pitches to this batter. Hasn't been able to put him away yet.
Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. He'll try it again, 3-2. Popped him up. Narvaez has a play, and that retires the shot. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring up Eduardo Escobar. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
Ball, that's upstairs.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
That's lifted the other way out to left. There to make the catch is McNeil, and there's one away. Daniel Vogelbach's next.
Number 20.
We're in the seventh now. 4-1 our score to this point. Hit in the air down the left field line, and this will wind up a foul ball. Bouncer to the left side and in the left field for a one out hit.
The center fielder, number six, Lorenzo.
To the plate now, Lorenzo King. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Hit back up the middle. Scooped up to second for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. Brad Boxberger will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Jackie Bradley Jr. is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. And he popped him up. Vogelbach trying to get there, and this is going to get down. It's a foul ball. Heading out towards shallow right. Garcia has a read on it. One away. Dominic Smith will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number two.
Eighth inning. 4-1 is our score. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two.
Got to find a way to scratch at least one across. You do not want to take on the monster closing the game down three.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight. Now back to the top of the Mets order, digging in, Jonathan Villar. Only four outs remaining for them to try and rally back in this one. Had the weight back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. The 2-2 one more time. Gets him looking, strike three. Seth Lugo is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 67.
Stepping up is Jackie Bradley Jr. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. To 2-2 now.
2-2.
Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eighth. Lined into left center. That gets down and he's got himself a base hit.
The bat, not shortstop, Willie.
In now, Willie Adames tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, 2-1. Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike.
This pitcher's bringing it with some high velo. You better get that front foot down early and get ready, or he's going to throw it right by you.
To the right side and through, a base hit. And they're content to play station to station here as the bases are loaded now with still nobody out. Standing in now, Christian Yelich. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2. Ball to short. Ah, way to get dirty. There's one on to first, and they turn the double play.
The batter, the right fielder, Avisahi Garcia.
So two gone now in the Brewers' half of the eighth, and that'll bring up Avisahi Garcia. Here comes the pitch for Garcia.
Oh, that's out.
Wong at third with two away. Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
Count remains 2-2.
It's going to be back to some serious teamwork if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. So here's Brandon Nimmo, and his guys need him to get things started here in the top half of the ninth. Swung on but fouled off to the left. And another foul ball. Ready with another 2-2. He can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight pitch at bat. And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Fouled away. Another 1-2 delivery. One out, nobody on. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. So here's Pete Alonso. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. The 1-1.
Wow, that's four straight K's. He's knocking them down. He's looking for number five right here. You can tell this guy on the mound, he is pitching with a whole
swing and a miss, as they definitely had him reaching for that one, and this ball game is over.
Well, in hindsight, it was the right choice to let the setup guy stay in the game and finish this thing. I wasn't so sure before, but the results sure speak for themselves.
5-1, the final total in today's game. The Milwaukee Brewers used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Brandon Woodruff gets the W on the mound. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon: for the victorious Brewers, 5 runs on 9 hits, no errors, they left 4 men on base. For the Mets, 1 run on 3 hits, no errors, they left 3 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 56 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon, and we remind you to please drive home safely.